kind of want to get some Bellona. Yeah, I want to play some Discordia, man. I want that card. Armored Behemoth. Wind Elemental. Hercules. I always want the early card, so Mercury. I'll take one Caldera just so that I get the flame tiles. Bacchus is fantastic. Tusky is amazing. I'll take the Marksman because of the amount of gods I've already got. Cupid to play into that more. Rain of Arrows is broken. Shackle is kind of questionable here. Vulcan's good though too. Sylvanas. I like Sylvanas a lot. Brontes for the mount. The mount of gods I have. Here this is a little harder. We're looking at Marksman and Inferno Cannon. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 already. I think the Marksman's gonna actually be stronger if you're looking at the number of gods I already have. White Tiger is really strong. Gladiator. Brontes. Stone Guardian. Tenacity or Gallus? I think I'm gonna be going with the Gallus. I'll go with another Brontes. Enlist. Got four more cards. Brute. Power Delve. Stone Guardian. Another list. This is not a bad deck. Not a bad deck at all. See how we can go. I was really hoping I was going to get a Discordia just so I could try out that card. I've unfortunately not got any in the 15 packs I saved up for, but as you can see, I still have 238 Canopic Dust. So if after I do these arena runs I still don't have it, I'll probably be just crafting it. Alright, game one of hopefully tonight's 12 win run. As I've stated before, every night I've streamed, I've always had at least one 12 win run to show you guys. So I'm hoping this, we're going to start out with a bang. Because I have three Brontes, I'm going to be dropping even my Tusky here, keeping the Cupid. Because if I get one of those Brontes, I have a great play. Not a great play so far, however. I'll probably, if I don't draw into anything, passing my first turn and coining into a Storm Guardian on the next turn. Oh, I did get the Brontes, however. I think I'll be playing the Brontes. I want to get an early game established. If he plays an Apollo here, I can run him in range and just Brontes his ass in the face. Weakening Curse is fine with me. Unless he now drops Apollo, that would be annoying. Cilia, interesting. I don't know what he was doing there. That was a really stupid play he just did. I'm gonna run my Brontus forward and just hero power him in. Kill him with the lava ability of all things, right? So now I've got either Stone Guardian or Cupid next turn. Looking like we can do a little bit of push here. Thanos, not a bad card. This is kind of hard, honestly. I think I can go long term and play the Stone Guardian. Playing the Cupid and stunning the Thanatos would have also ended fine with removing the Thanatos. However, by getting my Stone Guardian here, I'm going to be able to kill the Thanatos and further things, including, well, what the hell did he just do? That was a really strange play he just did. I'm okay with that, though. I'm just gonna start attacking everything he's got now with this Stone Guardian. Feeling good. That was a really bad teleport that he just did. Absolutely terrible. Oh, this song's dope. Back to like late 90s drum and bass stuff. What is this? I Remember You by Yuri Putzman. It's really Putzman. P-O-O-T-S. Alright. He's got the Spartan here. I can't move him back and do that. So, what I'm going to do instead... I think I'm going to deal with what's in front of me first. Then move. When I take a breath, you fill up my lungs. Move him into the fire and then stun him. That's going to get 2 damage on him. And then I can finish him off with the Stone Guardian. Depending on what he casts, I'm going to be running this Armored Behemoth into the fire. Get him back up to a 3-5-3 after that. I can finish him here. Move him into the fire. Do the damage and start powering up this Armor Behemoth here. I'll be able to trade with this Nike next turn, hopefully. Or I can just attack him with my Venator. Interesting. Death Monster 0115, I don't think is the best player in terms of skill, but either way, thanks for playing, man. I should have played this Marksman first. We'll be quickly closing in this game. probably be targeting my Stone Guardian back here, depending on how much damage he's able to do. That was foolish. Just gonna trade with my armored guy here. Start taking down his base. Get the Vulcan down. And start getting this guy in range. Should be able to close this out next round. Hades is not even scary when I have him down to 5 life. Let's be honest. Hades is not going to protect you from dying next turn. Good game, Death Monster. He also realizes this is not going to prevent him from dying next turn. Alright, 1-0. Only 11 more to go to get that 12 win for today. I have a good feeling about this deck. I have a feeling this is at least going to be a 7 winner, and possibly the 12 win for today. Let's get going on game number 2. Alright, let's see who the next victim is. A raw. I'll show him who's raw. It's kind of a hard choice here. I think I'm going to actually pitch the White Tiger. That might not have been the best idea. However, this also works. Sorry, Mr. Roth. Yep. Get the Brontus down. 3 damage is always great. And next turn I can double up on my marksmans, or I can move my Brontus in to kill someone I need to. Looks like I'm not going to be able to do that here. So I'm going to instead just coin into this Vulcan here. At the very least, I'll trade with his Gladiator. Oh, Fist of the Gods. Not a bad play. I'm gonna definitely be enlisting and hitting the Stone Guardian here. Getting a pretty good aggressive burst on him, down to 16 already. Good late game curve. probably be trying to establish a Stone Guardian with also moving this Venator into a position where he can strike something and kill it. Sobek, no problem, dude. See here, got a lot of options. Again, I'm gonna want to be killing this Sobek. I have a couple of options on how to do that. First, drop the Gladiator, and then probably the Marksman and the Bacchus. I have a pretty good backup, dropping him down to 15. His Sobek can charge and hit only my Inferno Cannon, which will be quickly lit up with the Venator after. His best play at this point would obviously be Annihilate, which would kind of blow me the fuck out, but I can't play against a Legendary and expect that in Arena, if you understand what I mean. What do I got here? Plus one, plus one. First kill off the Sobek, obviously. And then I'm probably gonna be just trying to take down his ranged unit back here. Playing completely safe. And also dropping the Stone Guardian. Three ranged units on the board. I feel like I can control whatever he drops by just moving whatever he plays into range of all three of the things I can attack. Is he gonna... Oh, he gives his base. I don't know if that's the best play there, but that's his choice. The only thing I know I need to kill is the Sobek, as he can grow in power. And go 1, 2, 3. Don't know if I want to move in range there. I would have to move in range. I think I'm going to leave my guy where he is. Move my guy forward to attack. And then use my hero power. Oops. I guess I already used my hero power. Well, I'm going to be taking 2 damage there. Which doesn't matter if he attacks me. He's down to 3 cards with me having a very dominant board position. I'm not really worried about what he can do at this point. I'm going to be taking him out either way. Yeah, this should be good game. I'll be getting stun on his Geb here. Getting him down within a lethal range for my next turn. And finishing him off. We'll drop the Wind Elemental too. This is looking pretty good. I think I'll be winning this game. If that's not obvious already. He is doing a desperation here. He's trying to see what he can grab. I have multiple guys in range of his summoning stone that can finish him, so don't know what he thinks he can do. Alright, sweet. We'll be going to 2-0 here. 10 more games for my 12-0 or 12 and whatever for the night. How sweet would it be to be getting that 12 win on the first run? I don't know if you guys were here necessarily in the last cast, but some of the guys had really recommended The Division, as it was $30 for the game and all the DLC, and I have to admit, it was really good for the $30 I paid. I would highly recommend The Division for the Gold Edition with all the DLC. I've had a blast playing it so far. I don't know if it's going to be as fun when I get out of the single-player campaign mode, but either way, just finishing this wonderful full campaign that I'm going through right now is already awesome, and I'm very happy with the money spent on the game. The shit? Do I have Wind Elemental in my deck? The crap? I need to remove that if it is in the deck. I didn't even know that's in my deck. That's not good. No, I'm just kidding. It's fine. I got Brontus and Tusky to follow it up with, so this is probably going to be a really good start if he plays anything aggressive and puts it in these front rows here. Nice name, by the way, Brofessional. Nice. My fiance just dropped me off a steaming hot cup of sake. Bong rips and sake bombs to all you guys. Happy Friday, everyone. I'm going to get aggressive here. By playing this Tusky, it's going to lock down this Argus in the back and open up a lot of play next turn with the Gladiator and my Brontus annihilating this Argus. As always, going against any Zeus deck in Arena, I'm not looking forward to turn 5. And going against the expected Hades. Interesting play he did there. So looks like he's wanting me to trade with him, which I have no problem with. Move him back there for the fuck of it. It doesn't really matter, to be honest. But Brofessional is gonna get a taste of my cheese right here. And if it is my personal cheese, it's gonna be some Fremunda, so he's about to get some. Turn 5 is a pretty good turn. What happens here is my armored behemoth of my own is going to be dropping. two, three. Unfortunately, I don't think I'm going to be able to get my Tusky out of the way, no matter what I do here. So let's just get some damage down while I can. It's against a Zeus, so I don't really have to worry about how I'm going to stack my guy up here. But by moving this behemoth up, he's now out of range of my Tusky. And while I don't really have a good turn 6, my turn 7 forward is extremely strong. He's also at a decently low amount of health, where I can be trading this gladiator into him if he wants to be attacking my gladiator here. Completely okay with this gladiator swap, boosting him up to a 4-4, where I will trade into him after that. A very interesting choice in made there. I'm gonna go with the Brontus and White Tiger play. Going full in here. Getting him away from... Yeah, let's move him back. I'm going to trade with his gladiator back here. And then just go straight into the summoning stone. I got him down to 10. With 10 on the board. So he's got to really address what I've got down here, or else just lose. And I'm okay with that. Of course I'm okay with him just losing. I also have the Power Delve next turn, which is obviously a great choice of if I can get a ISIS out of it, not as in the Islamic faction of terrorism, but instead Ooh, hold on. What do we got here? I could get 4, 6, 8 damage here on his hero. I think that's pretty good. So I'm going to be going... getting this brute here out of the way. And just going straight onto this summoning stone. And then... also getting him out of the way. Putting him down to 2. The opponent is really in dire straits. Because he has to kill my armored behemoth of all things. He has to kill everything and an 8 life creature to not die this turn. He's going to try, but because I am Bellona, there's nothing he's going to be able to do. Good game, Bromeister. Alright, we're going to 3-0. Only got 9 more wins to go for the 12 win of today. Oh, looks like I completed a quest here. Let's see what else I got. Play 50 gods. That's one I'll definitely be unlocking. before the end of this arena run. So, for those of you guys that are in the channel already, I was wondering if you've had any experience with Discordia, and whether she's as abusive as I called in my last Sunday stream as expected. All experiences I've had with her, which was playing her, has been she's been ridiculously broken. And she needs a cost increase and a power and toughness increase as well. The way I look at it is what she really needs is an increase in cost so that you're not able to swap cards with your opponents as quickly as she's currently able to. It's a real problem as it is. Alright, looks like we're looking at picking up our fourth win here. See what we get. A new wah. No problem. I don't think I'm going to be keeping this Rain of Arrows or the Sylvanas, but I'm happy with keeping both the White Tiger and the Bacchus. Picking up a Gallus after that is just gravy. Kendra Killer is going to be unhappy with seeing a Gallus of on the opposite side of him in an arena for sure. I know when I draft a new WoW deck, I am never happy to see an opponent's Gallus. Be playing my White Tiger on turn one. We'll be Crescent bladed into unexistence, but no problem. It means that the Bacchus I drop on the turn after is going to be much, much stronger. Because now he does not have tools to deal with what I am about to drop on the board. I guess that's a different way to get around it, isn't it? Well, we got immune to melee. I'm going to move him, however, into the fire pit. I don't know if this is going to allow me to kill this guy, however, but it should be something. I believe these will trigger at the same time and prevent him from dying, if I'm correct. No, I'm not. Okay. Awesome. It looked like he died, and the one damage from the caldera affected him before any health gain affected him. Okay, I'm going to be enlisting and finishing him off as well. And that's a quick a quick fourth win there. Four and zero is not a bad start at all, guys. And just FYI, if I get that 12 win on the first run, that doesn't mean I'm going to be ending after that. I will be keeping the content coming. And if you have any questions, please ask in the chat. If you like the type of content I'm providing, please add, follow, or subscribe on the YouTube or on the Twitch. Thank you. Guys, we'll be going for our fifth win on this next round here. Only seven more wins for the 12. And if we get the 12 here, we'll be going for another arena run tonight. God, come on, Hi-Rez. Just get me a game here. I guess while I wait, I can do a little bit of this Chewy OG. Alright, looks like we got a game here. Of course, as quickly as I load my dab, we get a game. No probs. What I'm here for, to provide the awesome content and straight butt rapings of opponents that I usually do in this game. Looks like we got Bellona against a Raw here. We'll be pitching the Behemoth, and I think keeping the rest. Shit. I don't really have anything to cast here on turn two. That kind of sucks. I guess I'll just pass. See what he drops on his turn three. I think I'm still feeling okay. Yeah, he empty passes on his turn two. I'll just drop my Bronchus here. Really not that intimidated. Just gonna get this dab off and probably drop my Stone Guardian next turn. It's Stone Guardian into probably Vulcan, and then Sylvanas. Just gonna curve all over this guy. He'll probably do that card on turn 4 that gives 2 poisons, but whatever. In that case, it might be worth just casting my Wind guy instead. If he casts nothing, I will cast the Wind guy instead. Interesting. I still think that a Stone Guardian is the better play here. I still got a lot of shit on the board. I don't think he's gonna be able to do anything. The shittiest thing here, I might lose my cannon to the... Yep, see, I'm gonna take 2 damage from this. Still think I'm gonna be able to beat this guy though. Probably just kill this guy first. Move him forward with my hero power. Kill this guy. Move Vulcan forward. And feel pretty good at where I'm at this point. I have a pretty decent advantage on board. And I think I'll be getting my 5th win right here. He could be annihilating me in a turn, but it's not the end of the world, really. Probably be playing the Brute just as backup here. If he annihilates on turn 7, I'll still be getting 7 damage on him next turn, putting him at 5, which is just an enlist or 2 away. So I feel pretty good at my ability to finish him off when I want, if I want. I think I'm also going to be filling up my pen here with some Leia OG. State legalized pot is wonderful. Alright, on my turn 8, I got a lot of options here. My opponent really does not. Move him onto the lava tile here. Don't want to kill him. Move forward. And again, I really don't see how the opponent is going to come out of this. So, good game, Zemeters. I've played you a couple times in the past, but I think I've got you on this one, my friend. Alright, guys. Looks like we're up to a 5-0 as our first arena of the night. 7 more for a 12-0. Let's queue up for another. 5-0. Bellona is my girl, though, so I usually do pretty good with her. Hopefully, Hi-Rez is able to give me a quick game. That's all I really care about. Just want to get more people playing this game. Sweet, it looks like we already got a game. Let's see here. Ah, balls. I just saw two new tournaments. One of them's on PC and one of them's on Xbox. But it looks like there's nothing here on PS4. I really do want to get some PS4 tournaments going. Bet it all. It's not too bad, I'll keep that. Against this Odin. Fuck, I'm gonna have to pass. Mercury should be pretty good though. Damn, I just won a lot of my self-currency. What can I redeem it for?
battle approaching.
keep a low profile.
Good will always triumph over evil.
Thank you.
Today I fight not for Olympus, but for myself.
approaching. Not call attention to ourselves.
Who's ready to party?
I'll come and go with ease.
All right, everything good with the microphone, guys? Well, that's kind of a bummer. I don't know what happened, but one of the people here said that they weren't able to hear the microphone, and hopefully now you are able to hear it. Sweet. I don't know. To be completely honest, it would explain why I haven't been getting people viewing tonight. Because, to be completely honest, I am a little buzzed. But it's because sake is a lot more powerful than beer. But my philosophy is... sake it to me, baby. It's looking pretty good. Yeah, me too. I like that unfiltered, milky-looking stuff. It's really tasty. Hey guys, I don't know if you noticed, but on screen, if you see any chests, please click on them. You'll be getting some Pankoi, which is the currency I use for this channel. You'll be able to request songs, become a mod, do many other things, including challenge me in a game. I have both PC and PS4, and I am very confident I can crush you in either. I'm just kidding. I have one deck that I think I will be pretty good in PC, but other than that, I'm feeling pretty good with what... what does he have here? Pillar Austerity. Let's just get rid of that. No one wants to deal with that shit. We'll play another Stone Guardian. Pankoi Party, that's right. If you have any songs, just click on the kitty icon on your screen. Once you've acquired 100 Pankoi, which shouldn't take more than 30 minutes or so within the stream, click Request a Song. Evie Cryptic, I'm sure you've got plenty. Request any song you want that you can find on YouTube or Spotify. Just don't do anything too bad. No Disney music unless it's from like Lion King or Aladdin, you know? Alright, I'm going to be playing another character. It looks like he's got a solid... Brittany's Toxic is fine. You request that, and that will be the next song on the playlist tonight. Thanks, guys, for letting me know that my microphone has apparently been off for the last hour, and I've been talking completely to myself, but I have had plenty of sake and beer to go with that, so... I don't give a fuck. I really don't. I've had plenty of fun reaching 9-0 tonight. And I think I'm going to be hitting 10-0 after this game. Things are looking pretty good, guys. Things are looking really good. I don't know how he's going to recover from this. I've got him down to 10 life. With more than 14 damage on the board here. 16 damage, actually. Listen. Alright, good game. Chillin'-ish. I'm gonna finish him off with this enlisting card. Alright, guys. Looks like we're going up to 10-0. If I get this 12-0 on this first run, I'm definitely going to be running it back and trying to get my first two 12-run, 12-win nights that I've done so far. But first things first, guys, I got to get two more wins to get that first 12-winner. Should be an opponent pretty quick, but otherwise we're just about 2 minutes at this point. Oh no, it looks like I got a song request here. Let's see what we got. Oh no. Toxic by Jamie D.
We got no problems to break it.
HotG. This is a long queue, 5 minutes now. Oh, I got the money in my pocket, but I'm happy, so fuck it. Yo, I'm feeling so fine, I'll be drinking my wine, flying high like a rocket. I got you, you got me. Well, I'm sorry guys, but this was on the song queue. So I hate you. Evie Cryptic, but thanks for requesting a song. You're the second person who's used Punkoi to do something. This one goes out to you, Evie Cryptic. I don't know why you love Britney Spears so much, but that's your own prerogative. Dude, I don't know if you guys have had the chance, but if you do like bitter beers, the new Sierra Nevada Hop Bullet, their double IPA, is fantastic. If you like the Torpedo that they put out, the Hop Bullet is just even better, to be honest. It's delicious. I'm going to be moving my Tiger back and then dropping a Brontus in the back as well. What face is pretty strong? This is not good. I think I'm just gonna move him down, hit him for 2, and then drop a marksman. And keep this Brontus back, to be honest. If he wants to kill off this White Tiger, I'll finish him off with my hero power and Brontus after that. Oh shit, I need to change this. Baby, can't you see? I'm calling. Looks like you're about to get a double dose of some Britney right here. I think not. No. Let's see. If we're going to be listening to some Britney Spears, there's some better songs than Toxic. No, we're just gonna find some other stuff. Let's go down here. Put this on. No more Britney Spears. Sorry, Cryptic. Can only listen to so much Britney Spears in one day. Just drop the Bacchus and the Tusky play here. As long as I get a decent proc on this Bacchus, this Venator is not really going to be a threat here. Where's the music, guys? Where's the music? There we go. Here we go. I'm going to put on a completely new playlist here. So, should be some chill electronic music. Oh man, he's going to kill my fucking guy there. Bit here. Move him up into the corner. Whoa. Digital Underground. Whoa. Someone just requested one of my favorite songs of all time. Whoa. I think Cryptic is from the Bay. I kind of want to get some Bellona. Yeah, I want to play some Discordia, man. I want that card. Armored Behemoth, Wind Elemental, Hercules. Always want the early cards, so Mercury. I'll take one Caldera just so that I get the flame tiles. Bacchus is fantastic. Tusky is amazing. I'll take the Marksman because of the amount of gods I've already got. Cupid to play into that more. Rain of Arrows is broken. Shackle is kind of questionable here. Vulcan's good though too. Sylvanas. I like Sylvanas a lot. Brontes for the mount. The mount of gods I have. Here this is a little harder. We're looking at Marksman and Inferno Cannon. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 already. I think the Marksman's gonna actually be stronger if you're looking at the number of gods I already have. White Tiger is really strong. Gladiator. Brontes. Stone Guardian. Tenacity or Gallus. I think I'm going to be going with the Gallus. I'll go with another Brontes. Enlist. Got four more cards. Brute. Power Delve. Stone Guardian. Another list. This is not a bad deck. Not a bad deck at all. See how we can go. I was really hoping I was going to get a Discordia just so I could try out that card. I've unfortunately not got any in the 15 packs I saved up for, but as you can see, I still have 238 Canopic Dust. So if after I do these arena runs I still don't have it, I'll probably be just crafting it. Alright, game one of hopefully tonight's 12 win run. As I've stated before, every night I've streamed, I've always had at least one 12 win run to show you guys. So I'm hoping this, we're going to start out with a bang. Because I have three Brontes, I'm going to be dropping even my Tusky here, keeping the Cupid. Because if I get one of those Brontes, I have a great play. Not a great play so far, however. I'll probably, if I don't draw into anything, passing my first turn and coining into a Storm Guardian on the next turn. Oh, I did get the Brontes, however. I think I'll be playing the Brontes. I want to get an early game established. If he plays an Apollo here, I can run him in range and just Brontes his ass in the face. Weakening Curse is fine with me. Unless he now drops Apollo, that would be annoying. Cilia, interesting. I don't know what he was doing there. That was a really stupid play he just did. I'm gonna run my Brontes forward and just hero power him in. Kill him with the lava ability of all things, right? So now I've got either Stone Guardian or Cupid next turn. Looking like we can do a little bit of push here. Thanos, not a bad card. I think I'm... This is kind of hard, honestly. I think I'm going to go long term and play the Stone Guardian. Playing the Cupid and stunning the Thanatos. We'll be right back. Nope. We already got a request. No longer a girl and not yet a woman. That is pretty classic. Say this is not exactly my type of music, but song requests are song requests. So thanks to my, let me check here, according to my leaderboard, Evie Cryptic is my number 5 most hype person. So thanks for listening, even if you request fucking Genie in a Bottle. Thanks for listening, homegirl. Alrighty, let's drop the tiger and start advancing on this guy. Oh, fucking Thanatos. That's pretty annoying. Let's go for it. I can't think of the name of that woman. She was like a... She's a singer. She was in a bunch of like teenage movies too. She was in like a ton of like... teenage coming of age movies. Looks like he's got that arachne down at this point. It's kind of annoying. Not the end of the world, however. I'm a genie in a bottle, baby. Come on and let me out. No, who is the other girl, though? I'm gonna be putting on some very, extremely, oh wait, no, here we go. Incredibly depressing music. Let's see here. What do we got? Here we go. This is not looking good, honestly. But I do have some options here. I am, however, going to be just playing the Armored Behemoth. Not happy with this Spartan with 2 protection. That's pretty a pretty big pain there. Let's move him forward. Mandy Moore, that's who I'm thinking of. Mandy Moore is pretty hot. Like, I'm just saying, Mandy Moore is really hot. Here's some depressing music for everyone's Friday night. I gotta admit, I do like Portishead. I really like this band. Even if they are like some whatever. From this moment, how can it feel? Mandy Moore was in hella videos too, right? Like, she's in a bunch of movies. Decent run on Scrubs. Oh yeah, I forgot she was on Scrubs. That was a pretty good role. To be honest, that was a good show in general. Like, I know it wasn't like Friends or How I Met Your Mother, but Scrubs was a damn good show. Actually, I should say it was no Seinfeld, because Seinfeld was the best of all of those type of shows. Comical genius. Man, I'm in trouble here. Let's see what we get off of this power delve. Oh no. This Ascentress is gonna do work. A Walk to Remember, that was the movie I was thinking of. Nothing I can do to get out of this. I'm just going to concede, and hopefully I can get 2 more wins in the next couple games. If not, we'll be playing another arena set here, and still going 10-2 is not the end of the world. Not a bad showing here. But we got one more chance here to try to go for that 12 win here. You see, of course I care. Hopefully I get a little bit better luck than I've been getting in the last couple games. Hopefully we'll be getting some wins here. We're at 10-2, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm hoping to get a 12 win on this run here. But if not, we'll be running back another arena run. And hopefully we'll be getting a 12 win somehow tonight. But it looks like we're getting a game here. So hopefully we'll be getting a win here. Looks like we got Bellona versus Raw. Always a favorable matchup for Bellona, in my opinion. Just gonna be passing my first turn here. Going into a Brontus and probably into a Cupid after that. Depending on what my opponent plays here. His best deck in the back. I think I'll be attacking this best deck. Playing a Rain of Arrows to finish off most of the damage he has on the board here. Not a bad play by him. That's enough, however. Yeah, no, I can kill him. My mistake. Should be. Nope, that does not work. I'll just move him back. Let's see what he's gonna do here. He shouldn't be able to attack any of my characters, but he will be able to attack my summoning stone here. Which, who cares? Really, who cares?
We suffer every day. What is it for? These crowns of illusion are fooling us all. And now I am weary and I feel like
I'm gonna go for the stun with Cupid. Shoot this guy back one. Finish him off and then just put him out of range. He's not going to be able to hit me, while at the same time I'm going to be getting a little bit more aggressive with him.
It's just a dream. We've crushed everything I can see. And this morning, selfishly, how we feel, and I feel like I do. It's only you who can tell me apart, and it's only you who can turn my wooden.
He's got a lot here, that's for sure. I think I'm going to play very conservatively here and just start picking off what he's got. As long as he does not annihilate me here, I should be able to take control of this board in a pretty dominant fashion.
Now that we've chosen to take all we can, the shade of autumn will stay bitter and years of frustration lay down side by side.
What kind of dumb shit is that? He attacked into my guy just to power him up? I don't know. Didn't seem very smart to me. What do I know, though? I guess for me, first things first is to kill the Sir Cat, see who gets poisoned. Completely okay with that. Just put some damage on the Sobek, move him into the fire. Drop the Sylvanas, and I should be getting the win very shortly. Well, that might seem like confidence or overconfidence to you. I got the Stone Guardian and a Brontus on board. I got a Power Delve in hand. He really has to address a lot of what I've got here. So what we're going to be doing is finishing this guy off here, power delving for, we'll just go for the Kamazots, just because he's got charge, so it's the immediate effect here. Move the Brontus forward and really take control of this game. I'm gonna ping this guy without any repercussions. Ping this Sagittarius, where when my Sylvanas comes back, this Brontus will become more powerful. And then go with the Marksman Bacchus play, where Bacchus will also become more powerful when Sapling comes back and becomes a Sylvanas. But this will be quickly a game for me. Good game. Take a ride, take a shot now. guess technically not good game for one more turn, but we'll still get it. We're gonna get this 12 win, guys. We're gonna get it right now. One more game after this, but this one is assured. Good game, my friend. One more for the 12 win. We're at 11-2 now. Final game, win or loss, this is my 12 win right here. Looks like we already got a game. See what this determining game is, if I'm going to be getting that 12 win here, or we'll be getting that less impressive 11 win series. Not the end of the world. 11 wins out of a normal game arena series is still not too bad. But it looks like it's going to be a Bellona mirror. Let me play this marksman. See if he drops anything on turn two. Just a marksman of his own. Caught by Brontus, Tusky, Stone Guardian. I have a lot of good options at this point. Blink, what did he do? The strange choice of play he just made. Just gonna play the Wind Guardian right in his face. Personally, I don't think that was the best choice of efficient mana use there. Same time, it looks like he's going to be doing 2 free damage to my summoning stone. Okay, that's not the end of the world. Go for. Now that won't finish him, unfortunately. So we're just gonna enlist off of this Cupid and see where my opponent's gonna go from here. I think I'm gonna be able to get the win off of John Ross here, though. Thank you. That's not bad. Not too good, though. Just gonna try to do some damage here with the fire, which I'll do back to him as well. Should be able to drop a lot of zombies on this guy going forward. Down to 4 to 4 cards, not the end of the world. Just need to get ensure this win to get my 3 packs. His Hercules play here is not the easiest for me to get around. Play the Sylvanas in the back. 1, 2, 3. Completely happy with the board state as it is. Sylvanas should be able to capitalize on this small board state and be able to get me my 12th win here. Jerk move, he's gonna kill my fucking... What the fuck did he just do? Did he not bludgeon the right... What just happened? Holy shit, I think he bludgeoned the back row instead of the row I was on. Sweet! 12 wins, baby! Alright, 575 favor and 3 packs. Never the end of the world. I'm gonna stream a little bit longer. Enter the Thunderdome.